Ladies and gentlemen, welcome into UFC. Here on the Fight Channel, ladies and gentlemen, we are hosting UFC 287, ladies and gentlemen. It's been announced here, ladies and gentlemen, for this show, ladies and gentlemen. I head to the arena for this lightweight championship matchup here, ladies and gentlemen. Let's see who it is. I go to the ring right now.
All right, so here he is, one of the better boxers in this division. Certainly has a well-rounded MMA skill set, but it's hard to lead the walk with anything other than the hands, which might be the best in this division.
Especially when you look at some of the highlights, right? You look at him landing that jab, and it's almost picture perfect. The jab lifts the head, the right hand follows, and guys are going to sleep.
Yeah.
I would love to be considered a boxer if I had the skills that this young man possesses. Be happy, because you've spent a lifetime developing it, and now it puts you on the cusp of UFC superstar.
He looks as comfortable throwing a jab as I do, like folding a slice of pizza in half, you know? Well, this guy has truly made the takedown a thing of beauty in mixed martial arts. With respect to yourself and George St. Pierre and the truly great takedown artists, this guy's closing the gap and entering that company in the eyes of men.
Oh, absolutely, because he's done such a great job of timing takedowns. I haven't seen anyone so good at slipping a jab into a takedown since George St. Pierre.
Right.
He does a phenomenal job of getting from step one to step two before his opponent even realizes, now he's in on my leg. And if they do get their hips back, immediately he's up into a foot sweep, or a headlock, or an inside trip. It's just so many different ways for him to get you to the floor that he will throw every single one at you every single time.
And a lot of fighters talk about that wrestling maintenance and how hard it is, right, over the course of a career to continue to drill those things. He talks a lot about that, and that's why he's continued to realize success here in the UFC.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is three rounds in the UFC heavyweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This man is a boxer, holding a professional record of 19 wins, 8 losses. He stands 6 feet tall, weighing in at 170 pounds. Fighting out of Beijing, China, Li, the Li Jingliang! And now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner. This man is a jiu-jitsu fighter, holding a professional record of 18 wins, 6 losses. He stands 6 feet 1 inch tall, weighing in at 170 pounds. Fighting out of Spokane Valley, Washington, ladies and gentlemen, an Ultimate Fighter season winner, Michael Maverick Chiesa! And when the action begins, our referee in charge, Herb Dean.
The veteran Herb Dean draws the assignment here.
Ready. You ready to fight?
All right, so here we go from T-Mobile Arena in Las Vegas, Nevada, and wherever we are in the world. Most fighters on this roster, to a man, to a woman, they want the chance at some point to make this walk here in Vegas.
You absolutely want to fight in Las Vegas. Before it was the MGM Grand, it was the Mandalay Bay. Now it is the T-Mobile Arena, the most beautiful arena in the world and the home to the biggest UFC fights right now. From International Fight Week to championship fights all across the board, you come to T-Mobile.
Strong bottom work here, staying busy. Accuracy and efficiency with these ground and pound strikes here. And if you're the opponent, you got to intelligently defend or the referee's going
to
stop.
You got to defend. But you can see him now starting to gain posture, and the intensity at which he's throwing these ground strikes is starting to improve. It's starting to elevate because he knows that he can get the finish.
3 minutes to go here, round one. All right, side control now. Oh, big combination of ground and pound strikes here, DC. This could be the beginning of the end.
I mean, you got to be very careful when you take these big ground and pound strikes. You need to control posture on the bottom. And if you're the top guy, the guy that's looking to finish, continue to gain posture and rain down big strikes here.
Oh, he lands another takedown here, just doing a nice job not telegraphing his shot. Clean entries. The Olympian's kind of like what he sees.
I mean, over and over, he gets to the legs before his opponent reacts. By beating him on the entry, now it's up to the opponent to keep up. But this guy's playing chess. His opponent's playing checkers. He's playing chess. He can't keep up once he gets to his legs. He's got to beat him defensively before he gets his hands locked around his legs or his body.
Really using his reach advantage there with that punch, DC. And he connects there, DC.
Great job landing that punch. You get up, you go down as another takedown attempt lands.
Under a minute to go. Oh, reversal here, DC.
What a way to switch the position. Fantastic movement by the bottom fighter.
All right, side control now, DC. You know he's in his element on the ground. A lot of tricks up his sleeve.
A lot of tricks.
Well, you know I don't like the gi very much, but I have an appreciation and a healthy one for these type of transitions.
You can tell he's been in a gi at some point in his life with the way that he moves so freely.
I'm skipping jiu-jitsu next week, too. Horn sound for the end of round one. We now take a look back at some of the highlights from that last round, DC. A lot for the replay guys to choose from.
I mean, these guys are going to be very busy trying to find what replay to show you guys. Lands on both sides of the octagon. Both guys fought great. What a phenomenal round.
Strike to the body, really starting to connect on a lot of shots to the midsection, and these will take their toll.
What a fantastic strike to throw at the exact right moment. He deserves this moment. Go finish his fight.
Oh, big left hook there. Now goes in and secures the takedown. All right, he's got side control here, DC. You know, he's got a lot of different submissions in his arsenal once this fight gets to the ground. Of top pressure being applied here as he works out of side control. Man, isn't it fun to watch this dude work on the mat?
He's unbelievable how fluid he is in his motions on the mat.
All right, north-south position now, DC. We'll see how he chooses to advance from here. All right, he's trying to control posture here. Now trying to hip escape.
He's just trying to move out of this position off the bottom.
Well, there are a few things more fun to watch in mixed martial arts than these type of transitions and scrambles on the ground.
High-level grappling can really be entertaining.
All right, working out of side control here. His opponent trying to control posture, but you gotta be careful here. His opponent squirming like a fish out of water now. The ground and pound is on point. This could very well be the beginning of the end.
This could be the beginning of the end. We've seen some really good ground and pound fighters. This young man is as good as any we've ever seen.
All right, north-south position now. We'll see who transitions first. Good work from the top here by Chiesa. Under 2 minutes to go in the round. A lot of top pressure being applied here. Nicely done there as he forces the miss from his opponent. Well, you see all the grappling repetitions here. Just beautiful movement, seamless transitions on them.
Over and over, these guys are doing things that you see in every jiu-jitsu gym around the country.
Side control now, DC. A lot of options at his disposal from here. Chiesa's got an arm. Looks like he's trying to lock up a Kimura. Oh!
Chase the submission finish.
Oh, that's gonna
tap from there as he gets it done by submission.
He got the arm straight. He got the pressure with his hips to force his opponent to tap, and he wins the fight.
It's the end of the round, and a lot of good offensive wrestling work from him over those previous 5 minutes.
I mean, great offensive wrestling. Every time he changed levels and got to his opponent's legs, he was able to secure the takedown. Let's see what type of fatigue his opponent will carry into the next round.
All right, so a wild round and a wild sequence there on the ground, DC. Talk us through the highlight.
He's such a phenomenal grappler. I don't understand how people don't know that this guy wants to submit you. He is the best grappler, best submission specialist we've seen in a long time.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Dean has called us off to this contest at 4 minutes, 34 seconds of round number 2. Declaring the winner by tap out due to an arm bar, Michael Chiesa!
Well, the celebration is on in his corner, and hard to blame these guys, sort of waiting to exhale, get a huge win tonight, and not just the win, but they get it by submission.
They knew what they had in front of them. They knew how tough a competitor his opponent was, but they also knew that if they could get this fight to the ground, they could find a submission. They found a submission. He got his hand raised in the way that he loves the most.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, what a great win there for Chesna. And that submission round 2, ladies and gentlemen, like what you're watching on the Fight Channel. Go ahead, hit that subscribe button. It's free, 99 here, ladies and gentlemen. We're going to have some more great UFC wrestling shows here, ladies and gentlemen. Make sure you hit that. Hit the notification button when we're always uploading videos here on the Fight Channel, ladies and gentlemen. We see you then. Peace out.